Welcome children. In the previous class, we had seen that matter is made up of particles. Matter is made up of particles. Now, characteristics of particles, we had seen first, particles are very small in size. This we saw with the experiment, with the activity, we put salt and then we saw that the particle size is we put blue and in the water and we saw that particle size is very small. Particles have spaces between them. This also we saw in the previous experiment. Both the experiments conclude that particles have spaces in them and they are very small in size. Now, the third characteristic is particles are moving continuously. Particles of what? Particles of matter. That is, this is pencil. This pencil is made up of particles. It is, each and every, now here air is there, each and every substance or each and every matter is made up of particles, it is moving continuously. Now we will see that with an experiment. How we will see? Now let's just take a beaker. In that I have taken water. You can see here beaker, in that water you can see. Now this is one substance, this is another substance. Both the substances are matter, this is blue and this is water. It contains the particles of water. Now this contains the particles of blue. Now the particles of blue will be mixing in C. You can see how the particles of blue are mixing in the particles of water. It does not have any particular direction. You can see here. It does not have any particular direction. It is moving sometimes here, sometimes down, sometimes here, there, up. It is moving in a zigzag movement. Now this mixing of particles, intermixing of particles, the particles of blue are mixing in the particles of water. This intermixing of the particles from higher concentration to lower concentration is called as diffusion. This is diffusion of liquid in liquid. Here you can see there is some zigzag movement. No particular direction is there. It's clearly seen. So, now, let me tell you what happens. This is one particle, this is another particle. Now, the particles are moving anyway. It does not have any particular direction. So, the zigzag movement of the particles suspended in a liquid or gas is called Brownian motion. Now this is Brownian motion. Now how do they mix? In a pattern which is called as Brownian motion. The phenomena of mixing diffusion. The phenomena of intermixing of particles of two or more substances from higher concentration to lower concentration. Is called diffusion. So this is diffusion. You saw just now diffusion of liquids in liquids. Now we can see another. So this is your agarbatti. You know that it is also called as incense stick. Now when you bring it very near, you can feel its smell, but from far away you cannot feel its smell. You can feel the smell of the incense stick more better when you, when it is heated, when you lighten this, you light up this incense stick. See what you can feel. See, you can clearly see the particles of incense sticks mixing in the particles of air. The particles of incense sticks are mixing in the particles of air, and even a person sitting in the corner can feel that smell and can understand that it is incense stick which is burning. Now, this is also diffusion of gas in gas. This is an example of diffusion of gas in gas. Now, diffusion of gas in gas, you saw. Now, what happens for diffusion of gas in gas or diffusion? What I told, diffusion is intermixing of the particles. Intermixing of the particles from higher concentration to lower concentration. Now, this is called as diffusion. But then, the rate of diffusion, here in this you saw, when the incense stick was not lighted, it was not smelling in the corner. But when it was lighted, it was lit up, the smell reached to the corner. You can also feel the smell of food, cooking food, from a long distance. You're sitting in class and you can feel the smell of the food, na? In the class. So, this is, this also shows that your rate of diffusion increases with increase in temperature. Increases with increase in temperature. You can, now from this you can see and understand that the particles of matter are moving. They are moving continuously. It means that they are moving continuously. It means that they possess kinetic energy. Now what is kinetic energy? Kinetic energy is energy possessed by, energy possessed by a moving object. So, now the particles are moving. So it means they are possessing kinetic energy. Got it? Now this is, now the three characteristics which we have completed is, particles have spaces between them, particles are very small in size, and particles are moving continuously. The next we will see in the other class.